Xavier, thanks very much for inviting us here to Brussels.
My pleasure.
Cofinimmo, obviously one of the leading listed companies here in Brussels, and particularly in terms of investing cross-border. Can you give me a sense of the investment strategy of the business?
The strategy overall is really to carry on building a diversified portfolio, but mainly focusing on healthcare. So today we have a diversified portfolio with 41% of offices, 41% of healthcare, and the rest are what we called distribution networks, which are really sale and leasebacks. We have one with AB InBev and another one in France with the Covéa Group. So the strategy for us is really to go push ahead with the healthcare business line and invest mainly in the Netherlands and Germany. These are really the two key markets we are trying to develop. Firstly, because we see opportunities, and secondly, because we are pretty much the leading players in healthcare in those two markets.
There's obviously been that change of strategy since it was originally an office-focused business. And what's that meant in terms of, let's say, the performance of the company?
I think the performance of the company has been more stable thanks to the long leases that we get in the healthcare sector. Originally, when we moved outside office almost 10 years ago now, it was really to secure long leases in an environment where we could have stable values for our portfolios, and also because it was more and more difficult to get quality investments within the office segment. In 05, 06, we all know that these were really hot days for investing in the office segment.
You recently underwent a capital increase. What were the aims of that? And I guess, was it successful? Did you meet your aims?
So it was really a true success. We were aiming at a maximum of 300 million euro. We reached 285 million, so success all the way. The purpose of the capital increase was really to finance the investment pipeline that was secured and also further investments for a total of roughly 500 million until 2017. So we have a very strong pipeline for the next 3 years that we need to finance. And in this position, after the capital increase, we believe that we are in a good position to basically roll out our investment strategy.
Okay, good. I mean, you mentioned particularly the healthcare sector in Germany and the Netherlands. What makes that such an attractive market from your point of view?
So for us, we've been heavily investing firstly in Belgium in the healthcare segment, then in France. And now what we're trying to do really is to diversify from a geographical perspective, but also from an operator perspective and from a security system perspective. So it's really building a strong healthcare portfolio, diversified healthcare portfolio. We are the leading main investor in healthcare. And for us, it's really just building that portfolio across Europe and staying a strong pan-European investor in that segment.
I also noticed that you recently acquired two kind of sport and wellness centres as an extension of a partnership that you've been running for a while with Aspria. I guess what led to that in terms of strategy, and do you think there's more opportunities to grow in that sector?
Well, we strongly believe that there are other opportunities to grow in that sector, and we view that sector as part of the healthcare segment, really. It's almost anticipating future problem, and we believe that exercising is probably the best option in order not to hit into problems as far as your health is concerned. So it was the extension of an existing partnership we've had for a long time with Aspria. We made the first investment with them in 2007. It was a good way of basically developing our presence in Germany with an existing partner. And the second element is really that we have long leases. We have long leases that are indexed and yields that basically are more and more difficult to achieve in Belgium and France. And that's why Germany, but also the Netherlands, are two markets that attract us very much.
And just in terms of that, would you then look to continue doing more projects with Aspria, or also are you also open to looking at other potential partnerships in those sectors?
I think the original idea was really to build that partnership, and we think that Aspria has other ideas and other projects, and we very much hope that we will be able to help them to basically drive the growth that they've shown in the past. Apart from that, we also believe that there are other players in the market. We have nothing in mind or nothing. We are not studying anything at the moment, but we believe that this is a strong trend across Europe and that is something that could help us grow within healthcare.
And Xavier, the office sector originally was obviously one of the main focuses of the company. What are the strategies that you're looking at, particularly here in Brussels?
Basically, what we want to have is to have a balanced office portfolio which shows strong qualities for our shareholders. So we really aim at keeping a fairly high quality portfolio. So there is no kind of wish of either diminishing the quality or the size of the portfolio. It's really, the strategy is really to do some arbitrage within the existing portfolio, buy new projects, upgrade the quality overall by refurbishing the existing stock, by doing some, for example, we do also conversion of office buildings. So that's a way of basically extracting value from the existing portfolio. So I would say it's being more proactive within a portfolio that will probably remain at the size it is today in the years to come.
In recent events that we've been running with the ULI and the RICS, density and sustainability have been two of the key themes. And I noticed that you recently produced for the first time a sustainability report. Does that reflect, you think, a growing emphasis, I guess, from the company in this area?
I think what we've basically, it has always been a large part of the strategy of the firm. The only difference is that we now label it in a manner that is clearer for the outside world. We've always internalized management of the portfolio, which means that we are very close to our buildings. We try to basically upgrade them when they need to be upgraded. We try to manage them in the best possible way, and we have an internal team to do that. So it's basically being clearer about something we've done for a long time.
Reconversion of office to hotels and residential is a big theme at the moment in both the UK and the Netherlands. Is that also a theme in terms of the Belgian markets and the markets that you're operating in?
It's definitely something that's happening in the Belgian market, something that we do as well. We've done two projects from office to residential for a total of almost 25,000 square meters. So these are really two fairly large projects for our markets. What we've also done is convert from office to a nursing home. That's a project that we've started a month ago. And what we also do in the Netherlands is we buy existing office buildings to convert them into clinics. So it's really a new kind of aspect of the property management we do. So it's just a way of achieving good returns and a good quality portfolio by other means than just buying existing investments and it's basically be able to be closer to the portfolio and control the quality of what we do and what we own maybe a bit more.
Thanks very much, Xavier, for sharing your views both on the market but also highlighting some of the investment strategies of Cofinimmo.
Thanks very much, Xavier.
My pleasure.